Hi everyone, my name is Morten and I'm an instructor here at FURUNO Maritime Training. Today I would like to talk about the no-go areas and how we use the user chart in the FURUNO FMD ECDIS to draw no-go areas. As you may know, the ENC charts are made with the depth contours in 5, 10, 15 and so on meters. So when you put out the safety contour on, let's say, 6 meters, then the system will, and other ECDIS system will always go to default to the next deeper depth, so it will default to 10 meters. But actually you would like to have a safety contour at 6 meters. So this gap here on 4 meters is excessive and will cause to give extra unnecessary alarms. So the thing you can use the ECDIS or the user chart for is that, let's say you just put the safety contour at 5 meters instead, then it will draw the safety contour, and then you could use the user chart to draw the extra 1 meter yourself. So this is what I would like to show you today on the ECDIS. So as you can see here, we start in the window chart alerts, and you can see I put a safety contour on 7 and a safety depth on 7. And you can see here it will now draw it on the 10 meter. It's, you can see the 10 meter here. So I have an excessive of these where I possibly would not be able to enter because there is the safety contour. But I would still, with my draft, should be able to enter it. So that's why I suggest that a way around this problem is that you lower your safety contour a little bit and go down to 5 and save. And then you see now it's different. And then you can draw an extra no-go area by yourself. If you go here to plan, and in planning, user chart, and I'll just move it a little bit so we can see what we're drawing. Then, of course, say new, save as, let's call it no-go. And then you have some possibilities. You have either the area or the line. Let's try the area first. And then you can see I kept this safety depth on 7. So I will give the spot soundings highlighted, which are below 7. So I can start by kind of, let's try drawing something like here. And then you might could do like this or something like this. It's not that perfect, but at least you would be able to draw a little bit no-go area here around. Unfortunately, we don't have the curved line here to draw, but you get the feeling. You could also, let's just try another way. I'll just delete this one. And you can do the with the line here, maybe more easy. This is more easy to make more nice if you just use the line, for example. The thing with this one though is that here you cannot get any colors inside, so you have to maybe make a title inside that says no go. So this is a way where you see here you have this area here. You can still sail past because in the system we'll always use the go default to the next deeper depth. So this is a way around the problem with the safety contour. So as you can see, you still have to use the no-go areas as you did in the old days where you draw them yourself in the paper charts. So this was my point of view for today about the no-go areas. I find it very important that you kind of use this user charts on this function. So, and if you are in question, I also have taken some of my info from this small pamphlet here from Intertango. They have some very good ideas on how you could operate your ECDIS. So thank you, and I hope to see you next time. Please send me some more questions about the thing I can do on the ECDIS, and then I will make a small film about it. So see you next time.